as our student speaker, Heather Cook. Heather graduates today with a BFA in theater and a concentration in original works. Heather's roles have included Nellie in The Rhymers of Eldridge and a very silly self-created clown named China. This past spring, Heather assisted directed our production of James and the Giant Peach, and she is currently performing in Shakespeare in Love for the Seattle Shakespeare Company. I asked faculty members to describe Heather. What emerged was a portrait of an unstoppably engaged student who is kind, thoughtful, generous, and supportive, who works hard and challenges herself all the time, and who has earned by example the deepest respect of her classmates, her teachers, and her department chair. I am proud and honored to welcome to the stage our student speaker for the class of 2018, Heather Cook.
Gratitude. We go into battle because the Pursuit is guided by our faculty. Impressive, outstanding, voracious, fierce, and loving artistic professionals. I figured it out first. The Cornish Bachelor's Program is the Kobayashi Maru. The no-win scenario. When you enter the doors of Cornish, they know how to get you. The principal lesson is to experience fear. Fear in the face of certain transformation. One cannot cheat fear. One must develop compassion for oneself and one's crew. That is the quality expected of every artist, citizen, and innovator. Your fear was never meant to be fought. It is a frightened child that has been waiting for you to become quiet and listen. I recall the exact moment I finally got quiet and listened. In front of everyone in class, I failed. Upon failing, my brain let go and my body woke up. I was a cacophony of gestures and noises, blubbering and sweaty. I cracked wide open. I rocked like a baby and cried. Colleen Rose Trundy leaned over, touched my leg with her precious hand, and whispered, "Welcome. Glad you can be with us." I was broken and have never felt so loved in my life. After this breakthrough, my shadows told me that moment was short-lived. Yet I didn't want to believe that, so I decided to engage in an experiment. I needed to enlist my brain to help me connect with others. So I gave my brain what it loved, an assignment. The assignment, at lunchtimes, I would sit on the bench at the entrance to Nelly's Cafe and Espresso Bar, where I would observe the campus environment, allowing myself to be seen. I expected to watch fellow students enter and exit the building and order food, be just another body in the room. Yet within minutes of me sitting there, one of my fellow classmates sat down to talk to me. And then another sat down. And then another. Immediately, they connected with me. Here's the broken expectation. I truly believe that if I met with my biggest fear, that it would hang on me like a neon sign. That once I dipped my toe in, it would swallow me whole. Yet I understand now, fear is overwhelming and uncomfortable because it wants to meet with you. Once it has been genuinely attended to, it just is. It's rendered inert. There's not only one obstacle for us, there are many as we continue to learn and grow. You need to know that the entire world is not on your shoulders. The entire world is harnessed in the touch of your hand, the sound of your voice, your heart center. We've heard, everything you want is just outside your comfort zone. But do you know what the actual breadth of that first step is? It's this. In this hall, you are surrounded by people who have traversed your path, who have supported what you've gone through and are here to celebrate with you. If you feel isolated, if you ever feel yourself receding, take that shaky step. It's this far. Our Cornish staff, faculty, students, fellow graduates, and families will be here to say, welcome. Glad you can be with us. Thank you.
Good evening. It's my privilege this evening.